You know what time it is. Time for an edition of campus, my campus life video vlog. And, you know, if everything else can be civilized about, you know, you guessed it. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, as far as we're concerned. Just remember that anyone else can be civilized about, yeah, technology. Or it's a social life, whatever it is. Now she wants to talk about, yeah, Green New Deal. Yeah, right. It is so ridiculous. Just remember that college students could be a Green New Deal receiving, having been receiving a lot of attention since she was, yeah, released in context of the deal last week. Just remember this. Remember this thought, because here's the thing for you right now. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, along with Senator Ed Markey from Massachusetts, has released an overview of their Green New Deal to save the environment. Oh God! And you know what? Among the liberal wish list items, wish list items about, the plan. The plan is to call on the United States to upgrade and replace every building in the U.S. for state-of-the-art energy. What? You wish. But did you know that many people are trying to ridicule the deal, which features all the plans that tries to reduce carbon emissions over the next decade, but the freshman congresswoman proposal received support as well. Well, did you know that Cabot Phillips? Yeah, I know Cabot Phillips on my radio show on the Blaze Radio Network. Many weeks ago, you were talking about. And that's why Cabot Phillips is from campusreform.org, tries to venture to the University of Miami to discuss Ocasio-Cortez's plan, yeah, the Green New Deal, with students engaging their thoughts on the deal. So, here's what happens. Here's what's happening about this one, because you don't want to know about the Green New Deal and all that. Listen to this from Cabot Phillips interviewing those college students about, and they love the Green New Deal. Oh, really, huh? Listen to this. You too? Listen to this from campusreform.org. And it's from youtube.com, so I'll check it out. And I'll check it out for myself. Listen to this. This is exchange about this one.
The number one trending thing on social media yesterday was her Green New Deal. It's a plan to combat climate change. It was already endorsed by multiple Democrat frontrunners for president in 2020. Yeah. Based on what you've heard of the plan, would you say you view it favorably or unfavorably?
I view it favorably. I think that we need to cut our reliance on fossil fuels. It's definitely a great idea.
I like that it's progressive. I like that it is going to push the world forward to where we need to be.
I would say it's a favorable act.
Just from like knowing like who's endorsed it and just like some like little things, it sounds great.
I think it'd be great for us.
I think if we didn't do that, then we're going to be killing ourselves, basically. So we need to take care of ourselves.
I think it's very important to support that.
Anything that would reduce our dependence on fossil fuels is really important.
I definitely support this movement.
Some of the things in the plan I want to get your opinion on. So the plan says within 10 years we're going to completely outlaw coal, natural gas, and oil. So gasoline, anything like that in 10 years.
I don't agree with that. To be honest with you, I think we need those things to live.
And I do not think it is feasible in 10 years. I don't think that would be something that would be able to be done in such a short amount of time.
I think 10 years is a little extreme because I feel like there's such a big global market and economic impact of oil businesses, albeit it might not be good for the environment, but you can't deny there's a big economic impact to these companies.
What's your thought on that?
Sounds like a reach, honestly.
You think that's feasible?
No.
If you're unwilling to work, we will still supply help for your salary and help for a living wage.
No, absolutely not.
If you're not willing to contribute to society, then I don't think that the people who are contributing should pay for you. So I disagree with that.
I feel like it kind of sends the poor message of, you know, you can just get away with not doing anything and, you know, getting money. It's kind of stupid.
I don't like that personally. Unwilling isn't the best way to go about things. Like, I don't want to go to college, but I have to get a job, so.
Everyone needs to contribute. That's the only way society works.
I don't know about that one. I think that if you're unwilling, that I don't know if you should receive money for that.
If you didn't want to go to class, if you were unwilling to go to class, should I still give you a good grade?
No. yeah, like people definitely need a job, need to work.
Eliminating almost all air travel with high-speed rails. What's your thought on that?
I feel like it's kind of the same one. It's like, I feel like 10 years is a little extreme for that.
I don't think it should be eliminated altogether. I think it's definitely, like, can be an option. I think we should, the more options we have, the better.
I think that's drastic. I haven't heard of that one yet.
Yeah, I can't see that happening either, honestly.
We've come so far to get to this point where we are right now with using these resources, and to say, oh, we have to get rid of it in 10 years seems a little too much to me.
Who's going to pay for all of it? Who's going to offset the trillions of dollar cost that it would be?
Right. I don't know. Nobody knows. Like, it's kind of like, who's really going to pay?
Based on what you've heard from these, does it change your perception of the plan at all?
Yeah. A lot.
Sometimes you need to take extreme measures to save the environment, but I don't think that is like...
Save the environment, oh boy.
It sounds like something I would be behind.
I don't agree with us having to, you know, take away flying in the air. I don't agree with, you know, taking away coal and things like that. And I don't agree with everyone getting money for doing nothing.
I'm Kevin Phil.
Now you know what happens. You don't agree with that. No, I agree with that. What do you think of this, Shazam, as far as we're concerned? So here's my observation for you. Asking the students about supporting Ocasio-Cortez's plan. And those who's, now here it is. Those who support it, it says, I like that it's progressive. Oh, so stupid. Just from knowing, like, who's endorsing it, and some... like other little things, it sounds great. No, it's not. If we didn't do that, we'd be killing your curious. You wish. I definitely support this. Shut up. I view that as not. You're not viewing it at all, and it's definitely a great idea. No, it's not a great idea. It's a bad move. How about, you guessed it, this Green Deal. Anything that would reduce our dependence on fossil fuels is shut up. But here's the thing. When he told the students exactly what is in the deal, well, guess what? Response has changed. It says, sometimes you need to take extreme measures to save the environment. What do you think it is, Earth Day? But I think it's too extreme. What do you mean it's too extreme? It has something to do with it. You always say these things. It doesn't sound like that, like something I would be behind. Oh yeah, right. I think that's drastic. To be honest, I think you guessed it. That's right. To be honest, I think we need those things to live. Things to live. I think 10 years is a little extreme. Yeah, right. But it's, you know, it sounds like a reach. Nah, absolutely not. And last but certainly not the least, I don't agree with us having, you guessed it. That's right, having to take away flying in the air, or take away taking any coal and things. What the? Well, now, so you see the moral of my campus life video blog story is this. Things a little bit change. I am going to be civilized about this one. And I cannot believe my eyes here. And you might think it sounds like Alexandria, Miss Cortez has a Green New Deal about environment and all kind of stuff. Shut up. Don't you think you've gone too far? You University of Miami college student buffoons. We'll find out what the answer is. That's my campus life video blog story. I'm sticking to it. Hashtag on the hook wires. Only on Facebook. Starts after this.